Rockstar NXS. Susie proudly wore the colors for the Chick Rockers, and then somehow you got yourself eliminated, but we were with you all the way.
Go. Thank you. Makes me feel better.
How was that experience at the time? You looked pretty calm on stage.
I wasn't.
Oh, come on.
No, not at all. I look back and I was singing very nervously. I was very nervous the whole time. It never went away.
You were the local. We were like, for those who may not be familiar, NXS launched a rather innovative, you know, reality show, and they were looking for a singer, and it ended up that another local guy, JD something, had the misfortune of winning.
Beninger, whatever his name is.
I don't even know his last name.
We were definitely behind you.
Venison.
So you had a few hits on the show. There was, I remember, Bohemian Rhapsody. Did you do Suicide Blonde?
Sorry?
Suicide Blonde?
Yes. Yes, I did. That was the song I got eliminated with.
Oh, okay.
Thanks.
Sorry for bringing that up. Well, it's in keeping with the tone of the song. All right.
No, I'm just...
Now, you went on to enjoy some recording in L.A., and I actually saw you at Canal Days in Port Colborne alongside Gord Johnson with Big Sugar. Fantastic night.
That was a fun show.
Yeah.
Always an honor to open for your heroes.
Yeah, well, where have you been now and then? I see you on some TV ads, and if I'm not mistaken, there's a voice of a local theme park down in Niagara that, was it Marineland?
Yes.
The voice of Marineland. Come on.
And you hear those about 80 million
yes.
times
it's
every
okay.
summer. I'm already sick of it, and it's my own voice. I was turning it up, you know, once or twice, and now I turn it off when I come on.
The belugas love you. It's all
really?
About the belugas.
Yes,
now, tell us about what you've been doing recently. You've got some new singles.
Yes. I've been doing what I think singers do, or people in the entertainment business. I think I cover most of the gamuts. And I haven't had a heck of a lot of time for anything else, but I guess that's a good thing. I've been working on my record for a while now, actually. The first record I made after Rockstar was sort of heavily influenced by the powers that be. A guy named John Kalodner actually was oversaw the whole thing, and he's retired now. And then the producer, yeah, exactly. A lot of people feel weird about him. And the producer wrote a bunch of the tunes. Then the second record I did with the producer again, Marty Fredrickson, he and I wrote all of it. And he's a great writer, so he took me under his wing and sort of taught me a lot. And then I thought, I need to leave the homestead and see how I can do out there in the scary world alone. So I just set up a bunch of writing sessions, you know, and traveled everywhere. I was homeless for just over a year, living out of my suitcase and just writing and staying wherever, subletting hotels, the whole bit. And then I just finished it, or I'm almost finished. We have two more songs to make, so I don't know when it's coming out, sometime in the fall. And then I'm on a kids' TV show, that YTV show that keeps me busy. I just bought a house and became a landlord.
Right, congratulations.
And I'm a mean landlord, I'll tell you.
I can't believe it.
No, I just knock on their door in my underwear, it's weird. No, I don't. And just playing shows, playing a bunch of summer shows, and then heading out on tour after the record's done.
What's the name of the record? You got a name yet?
I think it's going to be called Dear Love. That song specifically starts out the record. I had the misfortune of being dumped by my fiance, and it was the first time that I've ever sort of felt that way, you know, like you hear breakup songs everywhere. And, you know, again, they are everywhere, but I never really got it until I had experienced it.
Can that be a creative inspiration for?
Well, it totally was, and I thought, you know, I was talking to my keyboard player who's out there, not paying attention. No, I'm just kidding. We were talking one time about writing and you know, and what makes good art or what makes good writing, and he referenced the Zen of Motorcycle Maintenance, and then I had never read it, so I was like, well, what did he come up with at the end of that book? And he said something that is real and that is of the earth. And so at the time, my of the earth was this pain I was going through, so I wanted to sort of tell the story through songs, and I think I achieved that. And Dear Love is, again, it starts out the record, and it's a letter to someone after you've been apart for a while, and you're like, I'm okay, but I'm also not okay. And then it starts into the whole tale, and it goes everywhere from the craziness and the up and down to, like, we broke up 3 times, and then it goes into actually trying to date, like dating Hollywood men. There's a song about that. Never try it. If anyone ever wants to date a guy from Hollywood, forget about it now. I just saved you a couple years of your life. And then at the end, there's a song that wraps it up called Blessing in Disguise, and that one's sort of about, you know, you have to go through these painful moments, or really, you know, every moment, to become the person who you are. So even sort of the most horrible moment that you can go through in your life shapes you, and you should be thankful for it, because you wouldn't be the awesome person you are.
Well, that is a tremendous testimonial, and very Buddhist.
Is it?
We're influenced by all sorts of forces.
Yeah.
Positive and negative. So we are going to hear, I think, a song from the upcoming album?
Yes.
What's the name of the song?
This one's called Merry-Go-Round. I thought it was appropriate for where we are today.
All right.